because of this symmetry, their dynamic forces are decoupled in the following sense. The motion in this plane is decoupled from the motion out of the plane. So everything happens here happens exclusively decoupled from the other motion. So what is this plane? This plane is the x and z. So any translation along x, any translation along z, any rotation about y, this loop are locked together. And anything out of the plane, like simply sidestep, this little v, or yaw, anything out of the plane are locked together. So the 9 by 9, the first four, the 6 equations of motion are decoupled, 3 and 3. And in terms of the 9 by 9, they are decoupled, 4 and 5. 4 for the longitudinal. The longitudinal is the motion along the xz plane, is what we call it. The other set is the lateral. CLP due to Wayne. Again, the very systematic way. We start with the disturbance. C is nothing. C is coefficient. Let's charge this away. LB. Okay? So you need to apply a disturbance P and then look at what happens to your surface of interest. Usually it's a change in the angle of attack, which causes a change in the lift. And then you ask yourself, this change in the lift, how does this required thing, which is LA? So let's start with the disturbance P. P is a rotation about what? P is a rotation about what? X. In order to see a rotation about X, you see it in the other plane, YZ. So you need to draw the YZ plane, the YZ sketch. So this is this is Y body and Z body. The CG is right here. The airplane is moving into the board. Okay? So to decide the plane, the sketch is very instrumental from the beginning. To draw an incorrect plane or not convenient plane, you will not be able to see the effects. Then you apply a positive disturbance. This is P, it's a rotation about X. Like I said, X is into the board. Put your thumb into the board. This is the positive P, roll to the right. So you apply P. Okay, here's my disturbance. And I'm asking, you need the effect of this disturbance on what surface? I'm asking onto the wing. So you see, what does this P does to the wing? What do you think? This P, when the airplane rolls, what happened to the wing, this right wing? Goes down, right? Do you know goes down by how much? Well, the tip, you multiply P by this length. Here, you multiply P by this small length. So it depends on where on the wing. So you need to chop the wing into stations. This is a general station at the distance any y, and we take the length as dy. Okay? For this particular station, it goes down by how much velocity? This velocity, this downward components, how much? It's omega r, right? What's your omega? It's the p. And what's your radius? It's the y. It's p times y. Well, this is very important. If you don't get this, you have to stop me. Anybody doesn't see that this station will go down by a velocity p times y. The rest is relatively easy. Why? Because when you have any airfoil section or any wing or whatever was originally moving with u naught, now we have a little bit of py. What happened? Well, here is the relative airstream, the relative speed, and the airstream is opposite. So this is the change in what? This is the change in the angle of attack, delta alpha of the wing, and that's it. We gotta turn the crank. We gotta do it together, but we need to make sure that you got this point of view. Yes.
Can you explain the PY thing again?
Yeah, sure. rotation for any body, rigid body. Rigid body means that all points rotate together. And you have an omega here. This point have a tangential velocity, right? V theta. How much? Well, it's omega times the radius. Correct? Omega r. The same here. My omega is just because there are too many omegas. I have to label them. They are P, Q, R. In this example, it's P. So just replace your omega by P and your radius by whatever you have, which is Y here. So the omega R notion that you have from before is here, we, according to this naming, is P, Y. Any question about that? Okay, so the rest is easy. Actually, we're gonna have almost all of this. Exactly. That's okay, I don't know. That's okay, let's not to confuse you. So this is the change in the angle of attack of the wing, and emphasize the fact that it's at some station Y, it's not the whole wing. This is how much? Can you tell me approximately what's this? What's the change in angle of doing? Py divided by? Anybody doesn't see this? Huh? You don't see this? Just stop me. So, it will always be a change in the either speed or angle of attack. Mostly change in the angle of attack. So you need to know how to get a change in the angle of attack. This is a wing station, right? This is an airfoil. The airplane is moving into the board by a velocity u naught. So this guy is moving with it. Now the airplane is rolling, and we determine that this guy will go down by velocity py. So this guy has two velocities. As an airfoil, it was moving originally u naught, and now it's just moving downward with a little bit of velocity py. You need to complete the triangle to know the resultant air, the resultant speed. This is the speed of this guy. We always think, or like to think of it as, this is fixed and the air is coming in the opposite direction. So now ignore anything and look at this picture. This is an airfoil, and here is an airstream coming by some angle. Obviously, this is the angle of attack, or the change in the angle of attack. And in order to get this angle, this is just, this length is u naught, this length is py. This angle is 10 inverse py divided by u. And we typically neglect the 10 inverse because the angle is small. So the angle is equal to the same as the So this is why I'm writing approximately py over u naught. It's exactly going to be 10 inverse. Any question about that? Yes, please.
I'm just a little confused because the angular velocity p is if it's rotating clockwise and going down to like the point yb, wouldn't like if you think about it as downwash, wouldn't the flow be deflected?
It's not downwash. This is a very good question. Downwash meaning that the air is going down. This is the other way around. This is the body. The wing is going down, meaning that the air is opposite. The air is going up.
So p is saying that the wing is going?
The wing is going down, yes. This is the airplane, and here is the airplane. If I'm doing rolling, the wing indeed goes down.
I thought rolling was L, though. L is the rolling moment, correct?
L is the rolling moment. P is the rolling rate, angular velocity.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah?
Are we looking at the plane from the rear, or are we looking at the plane from the front?
Whatever you like, but here, since I said it, why this direct, why here, so what do you think? If y is to the right, then x is into the hole. Yes, Dustin?
Do we always use just the absolute value of p, or is p?
No, we have to assume p in the positive sense. So this is a positive d.
Okay.
So assume p positive, and I get l, whatever l I get, can be positive or negative. So I got the change in the angle of attack on the wing. This is immediately change the lift on the wing. Delta lift on the wing, and it's two-dimensional, right? It's 1/2 rho v squared. Area, the area is not the whole area of the wing, but it's c dy. Times cl alpha times delta alpha. Like what we did in the last example. Then we should turn the crank. Here is the change in the left on this guy is upward or down. This is an increase in the left or a decrease. What do you think? Come on, guys, just suggest something. If the wing is going down, it's as if the air is going up. The air is going up, it's pushing up. So delta L, here is the effect, the final effect on your wing. Because of the speed. And what you need from me, I need the rolling moment out. Can you tell me the rolling moment? What's the rolling moment due to change in the force? The moment is the force times distance. What distance should they use?
Y.
And it's positive or negative moment? Negative, right? Because it will be opposing the P itself. Or x-axis into the board, put your thumb with the x-axis. This is the positive sense, and this is opposite. This is negative. The change in the rolling moment is negative. Your lift force. Add the y section times y as a moment arm, and because it's different from a section to another, I will need to integrate. So a few times I'll need to integrate. And most of the time, like the last example, no integration is needed.